Hey guys, today I want to talk to you about student teaching tips. I had someone ask me in the comments of one of my videos if I could do a video like this, and I was like, yes, because I've been wanting to do this since I did my student teaching. A couple things to know about my student teaching experience. One, I did mine in Ohio. Two, I did high school, and three, I was in English. So just keep that in mind, but these should apply to everyone. Okay, let's jump in. Without further ado, number one, take lots of pictures. This is something that I really regret not doing. I got caught up in the moment and got really busy, and I was like, oh, I'll do it tomorrow. And tomorrow never really came. Take lots of pictures and have examples of student work. So this is important when you are creating your teacher portfolio. Your college will probably have you do it, and it is just something good to have. But when you're making that, you want to show student work examples and things that you did in the classroom. So I would say week one, maybe get your like classroom out of the way. Just take pictures of everything. Things will change. You'll want to take pictures later, but at least you have these. So I wanted to take pictures of things like we kept up with a giant calendar for assignments and things like due dates and stuff. We had a turn-in tray for kids to turn in their work so they weren't just handing it to me. Just things like that. Take pictures of everything. As you try new things and implement new systems, take pictures. As you get really good examples of student work, take pictures. If you're doing something more creative and like project-based, take pictures of it. Just take pictures of everything that you can. Number two, do not be afraid to ask questions. Ask questions of your master teacher, your neighbor teacher, your librarian, your custodian, your cafeteria worker, principal, anybody. If you need help with something, ask for help. There is not one person who works in a school that I have come across who's like, I want that teacher to fail. I'm not going to give them any answers. The teachers that I have worked with, that I have experience with, only want the best for the students. And if the teachers are succeeding, the students are succeeding, and that is the only important thing. So if you need help with anything, ask for help. Number three, do not be afraid to ask for lessons. It's kind of a known thing in the teacher world that people will swap lessons, that people will ask to borrow lessons, use lessons, get pieces and parts from lessons. People buy them on TPT all the time. Do not be afraid to ask your master teacher for lessons that they've done in the past, or a neighboring teacher. Again, going back to the questions, just ask for lessons. And it's not stealing. Like, teachers do this all the time. This is kind of part of the job, is to share lessons. Number four, do not take yourself so seriously. So I'm really glad I got into teaching when I did, because had I done this when I was younger, I would have just probably not made it, because I took myself way too seriously. And when I went back to school for teaching, I was kind of in my quarter life crisis, and I was like changing just my mentality and stuff. I am, if you don't know, a perfectionist at heart. I want to do everything right the first time. And I really had to get over that in teaching. And my mantra getting me through college was, will this make or break me as a teacher? If the answer is no, then just get it done. So I took that into student teaching with me, and it's like, if you try to take yourself too seriously, the kids are gonna see right through that, and you are gonna have an awful time, because A, they're just gonna wanna make you mad, and they are never going to do exactly what you want. You are never going to have a whole class of kids who is gonna do their work on time, who's gonna do it right the first time, who's gonna understand everything. Like, you can't take this so seriously. Just let things like come how they do, and if they're not perfect, oh well, did most of the kids understand what you were saying? Yes? Great. Those who didn't understand, go back and help them. If you don't feel like you are succeeding, that is okay. There are veteran teachers who do that. There are teachers who are 6 months from retirement who don't feel like they're succeeding. Like, you are not alone. Just don't take yourself so seriously and let things go. Number five, this is one that I failed hard on. Do not try to do too many new things. I was having a really hard time with some of my classes, just like talking and chatting a lot and stuff. And I was listening to a lot of educational podcasts at the time, and I came across one that talked about how to get your kids to stop talking. And a lot of it boils down to just having clear expectations and setting them from day one. And I had realized that I hadn't done that, that I had not told the kids what I wanted, and we hadn't come to clear expectations day one. So this fell at the perfect time for me, which was the start of the new grading period. So I decided we're just going to like reset and try again. So I implemented way too many new things at once. I'm talking like late work policies, classroom volume policies, starting a new agenda policy. Oh my gosh, just, I think there were 5 new things. And to me, I'm like, 5 new things, that's not a big deal. But when you're dealing with high schoolers who have 5 other classes besides yours, a job, college applications, like all this stuff, they can't like handle that much. So I would say, if you're going to implement new things halfway through your time with these kids, limit it to like 2, right? 3 max. That's really pushing it. I would say 1 or 2 new things, that's it. Number 6, make connections. So something that happened to me during my student teaching was that I had a professor who was adamant that you should not spend time in the teacher workroom, lunchroom, wherever teachers congregate, right? Because they were saying, if you spend time in the teacher lunchroom, you will have jaded teachers who will gossip about the students. It's always a negative breeding ground. Do not spend time in the teacher workroom. And that ended up being a really bad decision, in my opinion. The teachers I had lunch with were amazing. And yes, we do vent about students. You're always gonna have those days where you just need to be like, these kids will not stop talking and I cannot get through a lesson. And whatever, just get it out. In my opinion, there really wasn't that much negative talk. Now, that is at my school and with the specific teachers that I ate lunch with. I can't speak to your experience, what it will be, what it won't be. But I would say spend that time in the lunchroom or the teacher workroom or wherever teachers kind of congregate, because you're going to make connections. The lunchroom is where I made a ton of connections that I wouldn't have otherwise. I made connections with the Spanish teacher. Like, I wouldn't have seen her otherwise. Take that time, try out the lunchroom. If you feel like it's not for you, then you tried, you know? Making connections in teaching is huge, especially in student teaching, because those connections are what are going to help get you a job, A, and B, when you do get a job, you're going to have those people to fall back on, especially if you get a job in the school that you student teach at. Number 7, and probably one of the most important ones, is document everything. And hopefully your college has told you to do this, but I am here to tell you, this will save you so much. So document things like calls home, obvious, discipline, even little things in class. Document emails that you send to students, like correspondence about grades, things like that. Quick example, I am substitute teaching currently, and I am long-term subbing, so I've taken over for the teacher. I sent out emails to a bunch of the students who I was not getting check-ins from, because we are blended learning right now, so we have some kids learning from home. So the kids who were not checking in with me, the students who had not turned in any work, I sent emails to all of them saying, hey, my name is Miss Byler, I'm subbing for this teacher, I'm your English teacher, I'll be here until this time. I see you haven't been turning in work or checking in. I just want to see if there's any questions I could answer for you. Like, here's our Google Classroom code. Just gave them all of this information, right? And I saved those emails, those sent emails. I made sure to send them to a folder in my email, and I just labeled it like student correspondence or contact with students or something like that. And a week before grades were due, I had a student email their counselor saying, I didn't know that there was a sub in this class. I didn't even know I had English. Like, this teacher hasn't been in contact with me at all, and I don't know why I have an F, and this isn't fair. And the guidance counselor emailed me, and I was able to just forward her that email that I sent with the timestamp and what I had said. But because I had that hard evidence, it's kind of a strong word, but I had that email, it showed I actually did make contact with this student, right? And that is really important when you're doing stuff like discipline. Discipline and grades are huge. So I would say anything to do with those, document them. It doesn't have to be anything fancy. It could just be a Google Doc that you keep and you type in a date. Like, on September 5th, I pulled Chris out into the hallway and we had a quick chat about him talking too much in class. And that's it, you're done. Under 30 seconds, right? I cannot tell you, I could just talk all day about how important this is, but I will end it there. Like, just document everything. And above all else, have fun. Like, you're there to learn. This is the time to make mistakes. This is the time to try things and fail, because you have a teacher helping you. You have a teacher above you. You have professors that are there to help you. Just try everything, but not too much, right? Those are the top ones that I have for you guys. I do have a bunch of student teaching vlogs if you're interested. I can link that playlist down below. And if you have any other questions, please just let me know. I love answering questions. So questions, just leave them in the comments down below, or you can DM me on Instagram. Yeah, and that's about it. Well, I hope you guys found this useful. I hope that this was valuable to you. And if you are going into student teaching, best of luck. You are gonna be great. Have fun. All right, guys, that's all I have for you today. So I'll see you in the next one. Bye.